Hey, what's up? What's good? What's good? Welcome to Biggie's Gospel. This is Realm Reminders by Biggie. This is like a 10th take, people. It's not easy doing this live thing. But anyway, today I want to talk about wealth, how wealth wins souls. So on 2nd October, my friend and I have a company that runs social media, helps run social media for people. And so we had gone for this teaching for this company. We had to present, and during the presentation of the proposal that what we're going to do for them and everything, God asked me to give the gate man 5,000 shillings. Okay, later as we leave, one of the people who worked at the company, offers a lift, and I realized she was going in an opposite direction, and I said, you know what, I'm just going to use a surfboard. As a moderator for my surfboard, it takes forever to come, people. And the conviction still came back on my heart to give that gate man 5,000 shillings. I was really outside the gate. I had to go back inside and give the man the cash. And I said, here I stand. So, well, as I got out of the gate, God asked me to ask him, are you born again? Hey! I was overwhelmed. Like, this is happening too fast, too soon. I don't know the guy. Like, I was, you know, but anyway. Next thing I know, I'm on the border going. And so God whispers to me and says, it's that easy. Anyway, talking about generosity, realized God asked me to ask this man whether he was born again after a little generosity. This takes me to the scripture and chapters and story in Acts 10. So in Acts 10, we see this man called Cornelius, and as he's praying after some fasting, God shows up over the angel of the Lord. I'm not sure, I can't remember, but you got Bible, you can find out. Acts 10, so the Lord or the angel appears, and then he says, your praying and alms have come up as a memorial unto God. Yeah, saying unto God means an angel. So he says, send for Simon Peter. Simon Peter is in a totally different thing. Now you have to realize that Cornelius is a Roman and Simon Peter is a Jew. Back then there was a law that didn't allow Jews and other tribes to entanglement. Simon Peter is sent for. Simon Peter received a vision whereby God asked him to eat unclean food. Now, Jews were not allowed to eat unclean food. Like, that's why you hear those things of, you're not supposed to eat pork, whatever. And then God tells him, eat whatsoever I have brought upon the table for you. You shall not call unclean what I've called clean. So God was trying to tell him, God mentioned it thrice, trying to tell him, go to the Gentiles, like, go to these people that I'm sending you to. And then, of course, Cornelius's men come over, and Simon Peter, of course, is taken to where Cornelius was staying. And then, of course, Simon Peter shows up, and then back in the day, people were living in extended families. A household had, if you read the book of Abraham had a whole army in his house, you people. So those days, it was not this living of 10 people, but 5 people. No, it was like 100 people in a household. Those guys had huge buildings, huge mansions, huge, like, so imagine Cornelius and his household, they are there. I'm just imagining, he's staying with his other cousins. Just imagine he's the richest person around, the richest Roman around. And then maybe he has, okay, let's say 100 people. Like, 100, like, just imagine his clan all stays in that Kasem Kafunda. And maybe just imagine it's a Sunday get-together reunion, something like that. People are having a good time. His servants are also around. The servants, maybe imagine he has huge farm, acres and acres of sheep. And you know how money works anyway. And imagine he also has 100 servants. Those are already 200 people. Now also imagine people are passing by. Was there a party? Is there a mukolo here? What can we pass by? That makes it like 300 people. So that, and then imagine Cornelius has already maybe invited some friends over, other things. He's a good guy. What? So let's imagine the number is 400. Imagine it's 400. And the scripture says when Simon Peter came, so they talk about Jesus in their presence. Yep. And then suddenly they all receive the Holy Ghost. What that means is the baptism. What that means is 400 people, all of those people. Just remember, we're assuming, but then still the numbers are to the word. We have the word, and so it's not a lie. Imagine 400 people receiving that gift of speaking in tongues suddenly, guys. Oh my God, was the devil's funeral. Then someone to continue speaking, and then in the end, they all received Jesus as their personal and savior and are baptized. Now imagine 400 people now, they're all going around preaching the good news, spreading this. But it all happened in one day. And how did it all start? It started in verse 3 when the angel of the Lord shows up and says, the Lord has received your praying and alms, your giving. So I want to talk about our generosity. Remember, my case, God asked me to ask this guy if he was born again after I offered him some money. So maybe you're out there wondering, why isn't this so-and-so getting born again? God is yet asking you, keep giving, keep tithing to your church. You can even increase your tithe to 20%. I have done that and I'm seeing wonderful things. Keep giving to ministries that are building. Just keep giving. Because it didn't say, yeah, I'm not saying some things are only going to happen after you've only given. But what I'm trying to say is, it quickens the process. You may, in your entire lifetime, you may give. Perhaps maybe it takes you 10 years to bring 400 souls to the Lord. Maybe 20 or 30. But see what's happening here. This guy continues giving, and in one day, his entire household receives grace. In one day, they all receive thanks. You people, that is a bloody what? So maybe some of you are... Maybe you want to speak in tongues and it's not still happening. I'm encouraging you, just keep giving. Maybe you want your family, your loved one to receive Christ. Just keep giving and praying as well. Maybe we've just been praying, but I want you to try out both of those things and you're going to see marvelous, marvelous results. So other than that, I don't know what else to say, but just that story is so deep. I'll share the blog in the title so that you can read it, so that you get more, we know about the thing. But keep giving, guys, keep giving, for wealth wins souls. His giving, Cornelius, caused all those, in our assumption, 400 people to receive Christ and receive thanks that day. My God, who wouldn't want that? So yeah, I'm challenging you to increase your giving, keep giving, tithing to God's missionaries, God's work, God's everything, and you will see your family receive Christ, receive the giftings of the Holy Spirit without you even breaking a sweat. God bless you, God got you, and stay tuned on Biggie's Gospel Show. Bye-bye.